In this tutorial, we will go over samplers and how to create the following effect. As a base, we will be using the effect we made in the first tutorial, which is linked in the description below. Samplers are resources that give information to different properties of a particle system. Specifically, we will cover curve and mesh samplers. Curve samplers can be used to drive or animate any particle property dynamically. For example, it can be applied to the particle's color, velocity, or position. For this tutorial, we will apply it to the color property. Instead of having the particles be one color for the duration of the effect, we will use the curve sampler to animate the color over time. To start, we will create a curve sampler node in the node graph. In the Properties panel, under Custom Name, we will rename it to Color Curve so that we know what the curve is for. Next, we will create a curve over time node and link it to the color pin of the billboard renderer. Then, we will link the curve sampler node to the curve over time node. This will make the particles disappear. This is normal since we have not defined our curve values yet and the default value is set to 0. The color of our particles is defined by the values of our curve. In order to set these values, we will open the curve editor by double-clicking the color curve, then select the first keyframe, and change the position value to 1. You will now see particles rendering on your screen once again and fading out. The reason the particles behave like this is because of the curve we defined and the curve over time node. The y-axis of the curve defines all four values of the color, the red, the green, the blue, and the alpha, or transparency values. When they are all set to 1, the color appears white. When they are all set to 0, the color is black and completely transparent. Because of the curve over time node, the x-axis of the curve represents the normalized lifespan of each particle. A normalized value means that it is scaled to fit between 0 and 1. We set the lifespan of each particle to 10 in this example. That means that the lifespan has been scaled down by a factor of 10 in order to fit into the normalized scale. In order to set a different color than white, we will need to separate the values of the color into four different dimensions. This is done by right-clicking in an empty area, hovering over curve dimension, and clicking 4. Once again, all the particles will disappear because the alpha will default to 0, thus making the particles completely transparent. Select all of the curve dimensions and select the color picker. Choose a color and then set the alpha to 255. Changing the alpha is very important, otherwise the particles will not render. We can also add a keyframe at another point along the curve and choose another color for the particles to transition through. Currently, a version of the curve editor with improved color editing is being worked on. Next, we will move on to mesh samplers, which can give mesh information such as position, normals, UVs, and vertex color. For this example, we will sample the position of a sphere to start. First, remove the scene axis up node that is plugged into the local position to world node. Then, create a shape sample node and link it instead. Afterwards, create a mesh sampler node, rename it to spawn shape, and link it to the shape sample node. This will make particles randomly spawn onto the sphere shape. We are able to sample the velocity of the particles based off of the normals of this mesh. To do this, first remove the VRAN node. Then, with the shape sample node selected, under the Properties panel, in the Visible Output section, select the Normal option. Link the normal pin of the shape sample node to the local direction to world node. We can also tweak different properties of the mesh we are sampling. With the mesh sampler selected, under the Properties panel, we can change different properties to achieve different effects. We can change the radius of the sphere, its position, and even its shape type. The mesh shape type allows you to import custom meshes and sample information from them. For now, we can use one of the default meshes. Now, you should have something that resembles this.